In today's video, I'm gonna show you a step-by-step approach to fixing inside elbow pain we call golfer's elbow. Get up and get down, get up and get down. Hey guys, if you have pain on the inside part of your elbow, a lot of times it's referred to as golfer's elbow. This is the area most people have that pain that's called your medial epicondyle. That's where a number of these muscles that are on the front side of your forearm called your flexor muscles all come and attach. And that area can sometimes get painful. Obviously, we call that golfer's elbow. Even if you're not a golfer, maybe you're a weightlifter, a power lifter, you have some pain when getting into a squat that's leading you to have your arms all the way out to the side, or you're trying to do some pull-ups and you're having pain on the pulling part. Well, today I'm gonna show you a four-step approach that you can use to fixing this elbow pain. And that's going to be soft tissue work to the area, isolated strengthening to the area, and then we're going to do some flexibility and strength work all the way up the chain at the shoulder complex. So let's start. We're gonna come over here. The first step in fixing some inside elbow pain is going to give those tissues a little bit of love with some soft tissue work. All you're going to do is grab a ball. Now, again, all those flexor muscles that pull your wrist back, many of them come and they attach right here at your medial epicondyle. And a lot of times you'll have pain right in that area when pressing on it. So we're gonna take a ball and we're gonna be a mean massage therapist yourself for the next minute or two. You're just going to tack that ball down and roll it into some areas that are a little painful and tender. Now don't get right on the end of that bone, but stay within the tender tissues, the muscles and the tendons. And from right here, you can then pump up and down, tack it down and get a little movement with it, maybe grip and back. But you wanna spend some time like this and really find some tender tissues. If you find one that's really tender, hang out on it for a couple seconds, pump up and down. About 1 to 2 minutes. Again, it's not the entirety of fixing elbow pain, but it can be a very helpful piece of the pie in rehabbing for some people. Next, what we're going to do is a little bit of isolated strength training. Now, research has shown that isolated strength training specifically for the forearm flexor muscles can be a missing piece that a lot of people have that often goes unused in a lot of people that have a failure in their rehab setting for golfer's elbow. What we're gonna do is just take a light weight early on. You're going to even start 5, 4, 3, 2, very light weight with this. From here, you're going to come up and then super slow on the way down. Sometimes I will have people just perform the eccentric version of this. If coming up and doing a curl, if that is painful right now, we're just going to do the eccentric. So you're going to pick your wrist up like this and then slowly lower it down about 5 seconds on the way down. Get down to the bottom, you may feel a light stretch. You're gonna take the weight, pull it back up. Nice and slow all the way down. Something like this, I'm doing about 10 to 15 reps. 3 to 4 sets. Again, this should not recreate any pain while doing. And eventually we can go up in weight with this. Now, eventually, if you get to the point where you are doing eccentric only for your wrist flexor muscles, up to about that 10-pound range, let's start adding in the concentric as well. So you're going to just slowly come back and then slow on the way back down. Now, when you get to this point, this should not be painful. So again, if you have pain with curling your wrist at the start, you're just going to do the eccentric portion, assist yourself back up at the start. But eventually, as that is pain-free, we need to be able to add back in the concentric portion of this. So add that back in. You may have to drop a little weight to do so. But again, stay within that 10 to 15 rep range at the start. And then eventually you can progressively overload this and drop down to reps of even 6 to 8. So again, you can play around with the art of programming for this. But isolated strength training specific to the forearm flexor muscles can be a missing piece for a lot of the rehab that people do not hit when they have failures to rehab that elbow right there. Now, the next part in fixing elbow issues is to understand that many elbow issues are not elbow problems. That is just where the symptoms are. The problem often lies up the chain. And if we only isolate on where the symptoms are, we often miss the underlying why. And that's why a lot of rehabs are unsuccessful, because the therapist, the chiro, the athletic trainer they go to, they only look at the side of symptoms. You need to take a step back and understand the complexity and the interconnectivity of the entire body. Understanding that problems up here can be the whip action that leads to the crack down here. This is just where your symptoms are. Now, for a lot of people that develop elbow pain, specifically when they're getting into a back squat and have to get their hands really wide, it's because their lats are super stiff. So what I'm gonna show you is a way that you can screen at home by yourself to see if lats may be an issue that you need to work on. All you're gonna do is find a light PVC pipe. You can even use a broomstick at home. You're gonna sit down by the edge of a wall. Now, we're gonna do this in two different positions. You're gonna start with your hands in this position, okay? In this position, we're internally rotated. Your lats are a powerful internal rotator. So from this position, you're going to go up as high as possible. Try to keep your elbows straight, don't bend them. Go up as high as possible, sort of see where's your end range. Then you're gonna take your hands and you're going to externally rotate your shoulder. So what we're doing right now, because remember, the lats are a powerful internal rotator. By externally rotating, we're placing the lats on a stretch. So from right here, you're now going to, with that same grip width, elbow straight, go up as high as you can. If you are unable to go as high with your arms in an externally rotated position, it is a positive result for having lat stiffness. So again, hands like this, shoulders are internally rotated. Let's say I can get all the way up to my eye level, but when I externally rotate, I'm only up to about my nose level. So I can't go as high. That means I need to work on my lats. If you get higher or just to the same height, lats are not your problem. You can go on to the next part. But let's say you did have that problem. Let me show you a very quick way that you can clean up those lats. Again, this is gonna be excellent for those who have pain when squatting in the inside part of their elbow. All you're going to do is externally rotate your shoulder, grab the barbell like this, hand on top to keep it in place. You're going to lean back, swivel to the side, and bring out a really good stretch in your armpit region. This is where your lat comes up and attaches onto your humerus bone. So from here, sit back, swivel to the side, drop your head, 5 to 10 second stretch, and then back up. Okay, so we're gonna sit back, relax, feel a good stretch, come back up. I would have someone usually do about 5 to 6 reps of these. And then again, always retest, test and retest to see if the flexibility mobility drill you did was efficient and effective for clearing up the restriction you have. So again, if you failed this test, get right back under, video yourself to see if you made any change, get back into that externally rotated position, go up again. Did you have an improved range of motion? If so, that showed that yes, lat flexibility was part of your issue, and doing that specific lat stretch cleared up your restriction, you're good to go to the next phase of the elbow pain rehab. So knowing that is right for you is the next step. Now, like I said, a majority of people that have developed elbow issues don't do so because of an elbow problem. That's just where the symptoms are. We've worked on lat flexibility. Also, we need to work on strength and stability of the shoulders. Because if you are lacking in strength and stability, particularly on the backside of the shoulder with muscles of the rotator cuff and the mid and low trap, it can lead to forces being directed down at the elbow whenever you're doing a bunch of different movements, particularly pulling motions. So we need to be strong and stable here to allow the elbow to function as optimally as possible. Now I'm gonna grab a band and we're gonna start with some W external rotations. One of the most simple exercises you can do to strengthen your rotator cuff muscles and also your low trap muscles is called a W external rotation drill. You're just gonna find a light resistance band. You're gonna start, for most people, with a supinated grip, meaning your palms are up. From here, stand tall with good posture, and you're going to externally rotate and hold this for 5 to 10 seconds. Now the hold is key because our goal is to improve strength and stability. Remember, strength is only your ability to produce muscular force. Stability is your ability to limit excessive and unwanted motion. So when I go out and I add holds and tempos to movements, I enhance strength and stability. And that's an area that is often lacking in people who develop elbow pains. They lack strength and stability at the shoulder complex. Now this drill specifically, you do 5, 10 of these reps, you're gonna feel this really good in your posterior shoulder. So lateral, posterior shoulder, that's gonna be burning pretty good. That's part of your rotator cuff muscle group that is often a little weak. And this is also an excellent exercise, according to research, for improving low trap strength as well. So something like this, I would have someone do maybe 5, 10, even 15 reps for a 10 second hold. Now, if you feel any tension up here in the front side of your shoulder, what I want you to do is just bring your elbows a little bit further forward. Okay, elbows are still at 90, but I'm gonna bring them just in front, and then I'm going to do this. Now, you can change eventually and progress this to where we're going to externally rotate, and then eventually even raise your arms up into this position. So this is an external rotation W with a raise. So you've done 10 of them down here. You're then going to raise up. This is especially helpful for people who develop pain in that pressing motion or in that front rack position. Again, teaching the lateral shoulder muscles how to engage properly to provide a sufficient platform for the elbow to be in a good functional position. So something like this, again, we're taking our strength that's down low, but again, we're not operating all day long down here. We're also getting our arms into an elevated position. So this allows us to take our strength training up to a little bit of a higher level. So that is the first strength exercise in progression. The next one, what I'm gonna show you, this is particularly helpful for those who have pain while doing pull-ups. What I'm gonna show you is called a scap pull-up progression. The idea behind this is to teach your body how to use your shoulder blades optimally during a pull-up. So if you have developed shoulder pain and elbow pain particularly, which is the topic of today's video, with pull-ups, a scap pull-up teaches you how to coordinate your pull-up optimally to engage your shoulder blades first down and then perform the rest of the pull. A lot of times people develop that inside elbow pain because they're just pulling with their arms. They're not actually optimally controlling that pull-up through the foundation, which is the shoulder blades. How I'm going to do this is I'm going to perform 3 scap pull-ups. Eventually, as that is pain-free for you, you would then add in the scap pull-up and then the full pull-up progression. So that's how you would progress this. If the full pull-up is painful at the start, just do the scap pull-up. All right, guys, so that is it for today's step-by-step tutorial on how to fix medial elbow or golfer's elbow pain. We have that 4-stage approach. Soft tissue work specific to the area, soft tissue strengthening specific to that area, or isolated strengthening. Then we take a step back. We look at the body as a whole and understand a lot of elbow pain starts all the way up at the shoulder complex. So we looked at the lats and we looked at strength training for the rotator cuff and some of the mid back muscles. Taking that comprehensive approach can be often the fix that a lot of people need to finally kick this elbow pain to the curb. So let me know if you guys have any questions in the comment section below, and if there's any future videos that you would like me to make. Again, thank you guys so much for checking out today's video. Until next time, guys, happy squatting. They say that energy flows where attention goes, so I pay no mind. Why waste my time with all these negative cats scratching? So caught up in their egos, these people have lost.